Tuesday, I will speak to the nation about our urgent national priorities with meaning for believers around the world. Earlier this week, Jewish people gathered with family and friends. I speak to you today. We are closer to reforming the healthcare system than we have ever been in history. But today I'd like to speak with you about an issue that is fundamental to America's national security, the need for the Senate to approve the new START treaty this year.
I also want to speak to you about an issue of great significance to me as First Lady, and more importantly, as the mother of two young daughters.
When I speak to General Odierno and Chris Hill, our ambassador in Iraq, they continue to be overall very positive about the trend lines in Iraq. I know that NES is a young school, but I speak to you today with deep respect for Russia's timeless heritage.
It is a great honor for me to be in Accra and to speak to the representatives of the people of Ghana. So tonight, I return to speak to all of you about an issue that is central to that future, and that is the issue of healthcare.
I said this when I had a chance to speak to some of the NYPD leadership team last month over the phone, but I particularly want to express my appreciation and admiration for your terrific work, especially in the recent weeks.
Thank Mrs. Obama for inviting me to speak to you today.
We have a sacred duty to remember the cruelty that occurred here, as told in the simple objects that speak to us even now.
A year ago, I had an opportunity to speak to you about the national debt.
Forget that no matter what our differences, some things speak to all of us. Doesn't matter.
By necessity, leaders have to speak to those different concerns.
It is. Got to speak to some young girls in London about the same thing, and you know, it's a theme that really connects the young people of the world, and I'm excited to be a part of that. Now,
I'm here today specifically when I speak to the titans of industry here, because I want to urge you to join us instead of fighting us in this effort.
You're going to be hearing from my Treasury Secretary, Tim Geithner, who will speak to these issues in greater detail.
I want to speak to the unusual market activity that took place yesterday on Wall Street.
He said the speaker has come to speak to the students, and through the students he will speak to the world.
I'm going to speak to the nation tonight about this, but let me speak to the police chiefs and others from law enforcement here today who will tell you the same thing. These also had a chance to speak to Leanne Leonard, general manager of By the Sea Resorts.
Indeed, the tributes to Richard that have poured in from across the globe speak to both the enormous impact of his life and to the broad international commitment to our shared efforts in this critical region.
But we wanted to speak to you today about something that's very important to all of us, military families.
I can't speak to all of the policies of the past. In fact, NATO is meeting today as we speak to work out some of the mechanisms for command and control.